pointer with a second left. Celtics won 100-99, and they did it without the injured Kyrie Irving. Shannon, who do you blame for the Thunder's loss?
Russ and Melo. Mm. Russ and Melo. It's both of their fault. Because first of all, Skip, you know, entering into the season, Russell Westbrook was an 82% free throw shooter. Mm-hmm. He's shooting 73% this year.
Well, he shot 85 last year.
Yeah.
Okay.
So he's down 9. Mm-hmm. Carmelo coming into the season mm-hmm. was an 81% free throw shooter. He's 76%.
That is true.
Now, Paul George is an 81% free throw shooter this year. Mm-hmm. But we've seen Paul George miss some very big free throws in some very pressurized situations.
Especially if LeBron is standing nearby.
So yeah. if I'm Billy Donovan, the two guys that I want to have the ball, mm-hmm. Carmelo and Russ, because I know they're going to step to the line. Russ misses one.
He did.
Melo misses two.
Mm-hmm.
Skip. Russell lets Rozier walks up and hits a three. Mm-hmm. They let Jason Tatum drive the lane. Okay, you're up two. At no chance should you let a player get off a three-point shot. So what if they drive the ball and tie you, you go to overtime? Going to overtime is not a loss.
Mm-hmm.
That guy hits that three, there's a good chance you're going to lose this game.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what they were thinking. When you have this kind of lead, with this little time left in the ball game, mm-hmm. there's no way as a professional. And especially, we talk about the Brooklyn Nets. We talk about one of these teams. Okay, I get that. We talk about a team with Russ, a team with Carmelo, a team with Paul George.
Mm-hmm.
You have a 6-point lead with 25 seconds, and you lose. Skip, you don't lose in overtime. You lose in regulation.
Mm.
No, that's unacceptable.
Yep.
And I blame those two guys because they got to be better. Like you tell me,
it's
a free throw.
Mm-hmm. It's free.
Yeah, it's free.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And you up there with your own demons.
Yep.
See, I know a
guy. You've learned that from LeBron.
I know a guy don't have no demons.
Yeah, he's got a lot.
Got none.
I like his new routine where he does the exaggerated step back.
Yeah.
LeBron.
I like it too.
Step that left foot back and back to the line. Oh, now I can do it.
Yeah.
Well, you can do 72% of the time.
I tell you what he can do.
Mm-hmm.
40, 12, and 11.
Yeah, he can do that.
He can do that. And then triple dove coming on the bases. But you know who fault it is.
Now back to the biggest threat to Golden State in the West, the Oklahoma City Thunder. I love this team. And I've told you all year, this team has notoriously played down to the level of its competition. And last night's competition was wounded. There was no Kyrie and no Marcus Smart and no Jaylen Brown and no Daniel Tice. Daniel Tice is a good player. You didn't get that, but I'm going to bring it up again. So there are four key components missing from Boston. And Oklahoma City did what my Spurs almost did against the Golden State Warriors a couple of nights ago, where at San Antonio, they almost blew the game. They were down after three quarters to a team without Steph, without Clay, without KD, and without Draymond, who got hurt in that game.
Mm-hmm.
So it happens because you're trying to wheel the ball in because you say, we got to beat these guys.
Right.
And then the shots don't fall. But the irony of that is, down the stretch of this game, Oklahoma City didn't just play okay. Oklahoma City played great down the stretch until the last few seconds. But look what happened. They're down 82-81 with 4 minutes left, and Paul George nails a big three. Then Melo hit a big three. Then Melo hit another big three. And then Corey Brewer, with Melo hit him in the corner, and Corey Brewer just rose up and nailed it. Another big three. Then Steven Adams stepped to the free throw line with 1:23 left. Boom, boom.
Yeah.
Made both of them. And I'm thinking, okay, that should be enough.
Yep.
And then Steven Adams with 52 seconds left steps to the free throw line, makes the first one. I think, that should be it because now you're up four. And he missed the second one. So now the floodgate is a little open, mm-hmm. and here it comes. Then Russell Westbrook made two free throws with 24 seconds left. And then, of course, Russell Westbrook missed a free throw and made a free throw, so the gate stays just a touch open. And then Carmelo Anthony, who I consider a real clutch shooter, I agree with you, he's had some free throw demons this year. He steps to the line, and can we see the first one, he leaves it woefully short, and then you could just see his mind working. Here's the first one. That's way short. Now he says, I got to overcompensate. I got to make sure I get it up. And he just completely back irons. You don't see good shooters back iron a free throw except for LeBron.
My guy would never done that.
Yes, he would. He does that all the time. He LeBricks. But Melo is not a back iron free throw shooter where he just said, I'm going to make sure I get this up.
Mm-hmm.
And if you make one of those free throws, you're going to win the game. Now, let's credit Boston, because you want to talk about a valiant effort.
Yeah.
Because every time I look up, Jason Tatum's making another play, or maybe it's Greg Monroe, or maybe it's Rozier rising up to shoot the three.
Well, the thing was, Skip, is that when they were getting these threes, they were allowing Boston to come down and get layups right away immediately.
They were
basically taking like 4 to 6 seconds off the clock, and they had the ball in the basket.
Yep.
They stopped playing defense like, okay, you're down by this much, as long as we make our free throws. But that's here's the problem. You get shaky at the free throw line, and they, Russ, you can't keep backing up. You can't keep retreating and let the guy pull up with a three. You can't do that.
I think they thought they had closed the deal.
Yeah.
And then it wasn't closed. And then, speaking of, you cannot let them make a last-second three because it's a two-point game.
Yes.
So, can we see what Marcus Morris pulled off? This is as great a last-second three as I've ever seen on degree of difficulty, because Paul George is running at him, and he has the presence. Wait, here we go. Kick out. Look, he faked Paul George off his feet and had to dribble right. And then Steven Adams, at 7 feet tall, rises up over him and gets a hand. He contests it. And Marcus Morris still drained it. And I'm not, you know, I never consider him like the greatest three-point shooter. You know, he's a big man. He's not really by job title a three-point shooter.
No.
And he makes that shot. And, of course, Brad Stevens said after the game, that's a fall-away shot. Brad Stevens said, well, they kind of blew the play. But Jason Tatum made the play by getting in the lane.
Correct.
And so I would like to remind – what a shot that is. Wow. I know
a guy, but he doesn't step to his right. He likes to check his feet and step to the left.
Who's this?
You know who it is.
Oh, James Harden.
No, don't do that, Skip. Don't do that.
Well, you know, I just said something sacrilegious.
Yeah, exactly. The man upstairs, no, you
said,
can't.
Don't do that.
Yeah.
You cannot do that.
Don't put James Harden, that guy.
Okay, now I'm going to say something good about Jason Tatum. Are we sure he's not making a late case for Rookie of the Year in the National
Over who?
Basketball
Over Ben
season?
Simmons?
Yes.
Skip, you better stop playing.
Jason Tatum is the real deal. Here of late, every time I look up, he's got 23 more points. He had 23 and 11 last night. His averages don't look great for the year. He's 14 and 5, but he has made a late run with a beat-up, wounded team. I got to tell you,
I bet Ben Simmons wins Rookie of the Year unanimously.
He probably will. I'm just asking everyone to please notice what Jason Tatum's doing for this team. He is special.
He is, Skip. But Ben Simmons is doing something not even the great Magic Johnson did in his rookie season.
No, I got it.
The guy had 15 assists with no turnovers.
He did. No. He's a gifted passer, but he's also 7 feet tall. So he just camps underneath.
No,
he's going to get rebounds.
Yeah, why you do that?
Because he can feed Embiid. Because you don't think Embiid cashes in a lot of assists?
Yes.
Because he cashes about as well as anybody cashes.
Whoa. So now I didn't hear you say that about Magic with Kareem with his assists.
No. I don't know. I wasn't on TV then.
Yeah, you were. You weren't writing about it.
Yeah.
You talk about how great Magic is, but you ain't talking about how many of those assists came on the skyhook.
Probably a bunch.
Bunch of. Yeah. When Bron go get him a big guy, he can just dump the ball down to and turn his back.
When is he going to get a Kareem?
Yeah. Or Shaq.
You want it just to be unfair, right?
Yeah, whoa! Yeah. Was it unfair to Magic to have Kareem?
I don't know.
Was it unfair to Kobe to have Shaq?
But Kareem was already there when Magic came. Now, it wasn't like they had to go out and get Magic some help.
But right? You know how it was back then. Skip, they drafted Larry Bird as a junior. Back then, you could draft players and hold on to them if they went back to school.
Red Auerbach stole Larry Bird.
Yes. Yeah. He drafted him a year before Bird goes back to school. Mm-hmm. He gets him the following year. Mm-hmm. So just imagine if you could draft a player like you did back then.
No, that's true.
But I don't need all that. I'm going to do what I do without another all-time great player.
All he needs is love, though, right?
Yeah, we get love. Yeah. I mean, he got in that great clip, Chad Joy. You saw it. I don't know what he was thinking when he missed that three-point shot and started a backstroke.
Yeah, I don't know what that was.
So, bottom line on the Oklahoma City Thunder, watch them against the good teams, against the Golden States or the Houstons. They will rise and shine and make late-game free throws.
No.
This team is good against the better teams.
They are, no. What I know is that 11-5, but a lot of these teams, 11 wins, came against a lot, 11-4 in 15 games. A lot of them are in the lottery, like the Brooklyns, like the Phoenix, like the Dallases.
Mm. I like this team, like what it's made of. I like the way they competed last night. But listen, this
Boston team. Why are you competing against that team?
Hey.
You should have blown them out in the first half.
Well, I just told you. I explained to you. Sometimes you just play down to what you're up against.
No, no, no. You can, at some point
this
in time.
This Boston team's got a lot of pluck to it.
Oh,
you know?
What? Hey. They did come back from 26 on the Houston Rockets, mm-hmm. yeah. but they had their full arsenal. Skip, you can't lose when you got James, when you got Russell Westbrook, Carmelo, Paul George. After what they just did to Toronto. Remember now, they just went to the
hey, I know,
the baby
but
dinosaurs.
I went through the whole list the other day. They've lost twice to Dallas. They lost to Sacramento. They lost to Charlotte. They lost to Orlando. They've lost to a lot of the bottom feeders, and I don't know why. I think it's because they got the big three, and they think we're just all that matters to the big three is what's going to happen starting in April. So
okay,
are we there yet?
No.
We're not quite there yet.
But they're not going to be there. You actually believe they can beat Houston
I do.
Or Golden State?
I do. And I remember what, speaking of Magic Johnson, the great Magic Johnson sat right here. Do you remember that before the year started?
Mm-hmm.
And what did he say? He just blurted this out. It was just about the strongest thing he said all day. He said that he liked Oklahoma City more than he liked the Rockets. And that's after they had acquired yeah. Chris Paul, obviously. That's interesting.
Well, I'm not here to question yeah. Magic. I know he yeah. knows basketball,
yeah.
but I disagree.
Yeah, and Magic... Magic, so you don't question Magic? He's nope. the one who picked that number two overall pick.
Oh, yeah, right? Discount Steph.
Oh! You hear what Jordan
said? So you are questioning Magic.
No, I would not. No, IQ. No, no. I mean, he's a local kid.
Yeah.
I mean, hometown kid. Mm. I mean, you know, but he don't have no flip. Skip, he doesn't have that razzmatazz that Magic has. Mm. He doesn't have that gift, you know, that
he
ooh, that no
grow
look.
He into it yet.
Magic came in. You know, last
so he's a rapper. He's a good dancer.
I mean, you saw that. No, I mean, LeBron. You see LeBron, how he faked him out there and like, take that Zizic.
Mm-hmm.
He's a good passer.
Zizic?
Yeah, we got him.
You
we
got him?
Yeah. Watch what he do to Valanciunas.
Yeah, he probably will.
Everybody can we get a? Can I get a case of dew on tonight's game?
You cannot get a case of dew.
That's the best team in the East.
You realize you don't have Kyle Fourth Korver.
I know. I mean, I'm sorry. Prayers up to him. He lost his brother.
Yeah.
But you. Look what y'all got. Y'all got DeRozan and Lowry.
Y'all don't. Y'all me. Yeah.
Skip doesn't fall into that trap you do all the time. Well, the Jets draft Baker Mayfield. We'll discuss that next.